Here are a few more interesting things about St. Francis and St. Clair. Like Francis, Clair came from a very wealthy family. Actually, she was nobility, a social rank above Francis, whose merchant father was still considered a lower class in spite of his accumulated wealth. Clair is often depicted holding a consecrated host because it's said she used it to ward off invaders from the Saracens in 1240 and local thugs. Also, bedridden and ill on Christmas Eve of 1252, Clair was unable to go to Mass and listen to the Franciscan singing in the new St. Francis Basilica. Suddenly, she was blessed with a vision of the Mass, both hearing and seeing it miraculously from several miles away. So, in 1958, she was declared the patron saint of television and sore eyes by the Pope. Inside the Church of St. Clair or Santa Chiara, you can see not only the original crucifix that spoke to St. Francis and the body of St. Clair, but some holy relics such as tunics worn by Francis and Clair, a nightshirt she embroidered, and some of the hair Francis cut from her head when she converted and joined the Franciscans. You'll notice the tunics are in the shape of a T. That was because Francis purposely fashioned his friar habit to form a cross. Francis also signed his name with a T, the Greek tau, that he greatly venerated. Contemporary Franciscans adopted a simple wooden tower cross in honor of the St. Francis symbol. In Assisi, most of these tower crosses are made of olive wood, a sacred wood that the cross of Jesus was made from as well. St. Francis is said to be the first in a couple of significant things. He was the first noted to have received the stigmata. After him, about 300 accounts have been counted to date. He was also the first to recreate the nativity scene in Greccio using live ox and donkeys inside a real manger. Interestingly, he was also born in a manger when his mother, unable to deliver him at birth, was told by a mysterious visitor to go give birth in the hay in the manger, and there Francis was born. Francis was not given this name at birth. He was named and baptized Giovanni or John. During this time, his father Pietro Bernardone was in France on business. When he returned, he changed his son's name from Giovanni to Francesco, a very unusual name for that time because it translated to the Frenchman. Some say it was to pay respect to France, the country that he did so much business with and became very wealthy. And some say it was to honor his wife Pica, the mother of St. Francis, who was originally from France. When Francis died, he was blind and had endured two failed medieval eye surgeries by having his temples cauterized with hot irons. It's said he prayed to Brother Fire to be courteous to him, and astonished bystanders claimed Francis showed no sign of pain one would normally experience during such extreme procedures. And he did this twice. And it was during the agony of his illness and constant pain that he composed his famous Canticle of the Creatures.
Thank you.
the hordes of tourists and nuns with cell phones and stylish locals, Assisi hasn't changed much since the days of St. Francis during the medieval period. The pink and gray buildings that seem to crawl up the slope of Mount Subasio have been admiring the incomparable panoramic view below for some 800 years. One big difference you notice today is that the streets are far cleaner than they were back then. In fact, some of the arched passages you see connecting the buildings were used by nobility and nuns to cross from one building to another without touching the filthy and infested streets below. That was common during the medieval times. Hygiene wasn't a priority. The streets weren't always as pristine and quiet as they are today when Francis grew up. Brawls, public executions, thieves and beggars all shared the same streets and piazzas with the clergy and nobility and merchants. Ah, the things the streets and buildings have witnessed. But I imagine even back then, people thought, as they think today, that Assisi is one of the most beautiful and magical places in the world.